If you value your lives, be somewhere else. And yes, that is a quote from the sci-fi series Babylon 5, but in this case, I am applying it to a potentially highly dangerous volcanic situation that is currently unfolding within Ethiopia. Listen up, as a lot of people could end up dying if a worst-case scenario does occur, and yes, I am going to get pushback for posting this, but I can't have this on my conscience of not saying something if disaster, while still highly unlikely, does strike. Here is the current situation. 131 kilometers east of Ethiopia's capital, Addis Ababa, a tabular body of magma that is 35 kilometers or 21.7 miles long is rising between the outskirts of the Fentale and Dofan stratovolcanoes. When dikes solidify, they look like this, so this cross-section displays what the body of rising magma might look like at the present. As this magma has pushed overlying rock upwards, it has formed large cracks in the ground and created dozens of magnitude 4 and 5 earthquakes. Regional structures are not built to withstand these moderate quakes, largely being built from concrete or brick, and as a result, 30 have collapsed and hundreds have been damaged. This in of itself is enough to warrant regional evacuations even if a volcanic eruption does not end up occurring. Yes, you cannot predict earthquakes, but this is a rare scenario where a unique trigger, i.e. magma, is likely to generate more of the same in upcoming days. Unlike a prior magma dike intrusion which occurred in the exact same location during late September and early October that was less than half of the current dike's length, seismic activity has not petered out but instead escalated with each day, a bad sign, mind you. Then, earlier today on January 3, 2025, a vent opened up 8.4 kilometers north-northeast of the Fentale volcano, generating multiple explosions that hurled mud and rock and generated a large steam plume visible from afar. Based on posted social media footage, I cannot tell if these are simple albeit violently newly formed mud volcanoes, hydrothermal explosions, or an actual albeit weak series of phreatic eruptions. Whatever is the case, while this is the least likely explanation, it is best to assume that these are the most concerning of the three phreatic eruptions. These are caused when shallow magma transfers residual heat to overlying groundwater, causing it to flash to steam and then explode, fragmenting overlying ground without directly releasing any actual lava. These types of phreatic eruptions can occur in isolation, but often occur during the beginning stages of a much larger magmatic eruption. But wait, I can hear other volcanologists in my audience saying out loud, why would you treat these explosions as phreatic eruptions when you said that they probably aren't these? My answer is a lack of decent data involving the current unrest. If I was to see the exact same unrest playing out in Ethiopia instead occur at, say, Hawaii's Kilauea volcano, the significant amount of sensors present would allow me to greatly narrow down the range of likely possible outcomes. However, with this magma dike in Ethiopia, I only have a once every 5 to 6 day satellite dataset that detects ground deformation, which is indeed occurring, along with social media footage and a single seismometer in Addis Ababa. At such a distance away from the current unrest, that seismometer is likely missing any harmonic tremor or volcanic tremor which could be occurring, and it cannot identify various types of earthquakes which are important to figure out what exactly is occurring at a volcano experiencing a period of unrest. In other words, due to a lack of data, I cannot narrow down the series of reasonable outcomes, so it is generally best to assume the worst when discussing disaster prevention to save lives. If you need to pause the video, I have left another analogy on screen to help explain the problem we are dealing with. While statistically, a true volcanic eruption not occurring is the most likely outcome, I do not know for sure what could reasonably happen next, and this is quite dangerous. As if an eruption was to occur, it would almost certainly be some degree of explosive, even having the potential to devastate the surrounding landscape for multiple miles. The Ethiopian government has begun evacuating people around the dike, but I still see people filming up close to the steam-producing vents. Please, get out of there. Don't do that. Get far away. These steam-producing vents could be producing lethal levels of volcanic gases and also might represent the most likely spot for a volcanic eruption to occur, which could, without warning, cause various hazards that are unsafe to be within multiple miles of. I really do not want to cause unnecessary panic, but I also do not want to see anyone die from what could be a preventable death at this point. I'd rather authorities and people overreact and end up being wrong, rather than underreact and possibly result in tragedy. Stay safe, everyone, and stay tuned for more updates.